So now I'll spend a little time in some smart finishes and how to do some seamless chord wise kind of things. Okay, how many of you are actually mathematics students or at least interested in mathematics? Okay, good. That's a very, very sizable number. Only a few of you are like those who have either left mathematics behind or whom mathematics has left behind. Nice. Smart finishes is a term I use, but the concept has been practiced by so many musicians before. A lot of musicians have been smart and they were given a lot of good finishes. Okay? And it can be of so many different types. Now, if you actually look at some of these compositions, even in Kritis, the way they'll render the swaram will dovetail into the pattern of the song, right? That is also smart if you do it sometimes, right? My desune garitra divani sanid manasuna. It's a smart thing, right? It dovetails with that manasuna kind of thing. So like this, you can do so many things to that. But if you want to make it smarter, digaritra divani nitanid the manasuna. What did you do now? Takita manasuna is there actually. So garitra divani sanid manasu. How much is that? Basically it's only 3 sixes. Okay. Tadimtam, 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 manasu. It just goes to that, right? And next time what I did? But plus 2 for how many patterns? 4 patterns. Why? Even for that manasu, I am adding that plus 2. Only then that will sound smart over there. So, digaritra sadhisani nitanid the manasuna. So, like that. So, you can keep on doing that. So, how much did you subtract to get to this pattern? Or how much did you add to get to that pattern from the first one? Where did the first pattern start from? How much? Yeah, you have to add that, but where did the first one start? One before, right? It starts one before the talam. So 13 out of 14, right? So then if you want to add 2, 4 times, take it another 5, another 8 before, which is after 5 in the talam, right? So this is one small example of a smart finish. Now you can extend this several times. No, after one you should take that. But you are doing 3, you are adding to that. Right? It's one smart way to do this. Now, this is just one example or one type of smartness. Let's look at some other example. Adi Talam has in one kalai how many aksharams? 32 if you are having 4 per beat, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4 into 8 is 32. So now a simple thing is any even number can be expressed as a sum of 4 terms. Now if it is 32, how will you express 32 as a sum of 4 times, 4 terms? 8 plus 8 plus 8 plus 8 is a very, very obvious answer. It is divisible by that one. That's fine. Okay. But if you want it to be 4 ascending terms and not just even terms, so then how can you do that? I can't hear. Tell me louder. 6 plus? 6 plus 2? 6 plus 2 is 8 only, no? Ascending terms, each term should be higher than the previous term. Two, six, 10, 14, right? So that is one way to do the two. So how did you arrive at that answer for the benefit of other students?
Like some progression.
6 plus 10 plus 10.
No, but then 6 is the same as 6, no? And 10 is also the same as 10. Increase by 4, you are getting that. But then how did you hit upon the 2 as the first term? Suppose, why don't you take 3 and then add, keep adding 4 and then you wouldn't get it, right? So how did somebody decide that 2 should be the first term? That. How does anyone decide? Lowest divisor? How do you explain? Now suppose I give you a number like 60. Then how will you decide what is the lowest divisor in that and then keep adding how much to that to get to 60? His answer was correct only.
8 minus 6, 8 plus 6. 8 minus 4, 8 plus 4.
Well, that is one way to look at it. A simpler way to look at it is that.
So maybe if we have 4 sets of numbers, 2 of them should be sum up to half of the weight, another 2 to this.
Yeah.
Like 14 plus 2 is 16.
Yeah, in other words, if you actually hit at numbers where the middle two terms are half of the overall term, okay, then that's one of the ways to do this. Now, for example, 5, 7, 9, 11. Okay. So the middle two terms, so just get to that middle two terms always. Keep in your mind, 32 means the middle two terms should be 7 and 9, which is 16, which is going to be half of the 32, right? So if you want it to be 6, then that next term has to be 10, 6 plus 10. So then you can get to the other terms. So whatever difference is here, that is going to be extrapolated to that. So then what happens? This is just one way to look at 32. If I say 36, what happens? Give me an example now. 36, what will be the answer? Middle two terms should be 18. So? You can have 10 and 8, right? 8 and 10 as the middle terms. Then another 2 minus is going to be 6. And then another 2 plus to that 10 is going to be 12. Right? It's one way to look at it. You can, why I'm saying all this, you get the principles right, then you should be able to calculate all this within a fraction of a second on stage when you render this. What we are doing here, we won't have this amount of luxury of time to be calculating on stage. So your process should be very fast for you to get immediately to the answer. Now if you want 62, what is half of 62?
31.
So the middle two terms should be at least 15 and 16, right? Then 14, 15, 16, 17. Get the picture like this. That's all time you will have reflex before the violinist finishes their round. You have to think like on stage. How can you do this? 74. 18, 19 means 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, right? So this is the first part of the problem. This was really, believe it or not, the easy part of the problem. Okay? The difficult part is to find the correct swarams to express that idea. And find the correct swarams not only in just one or two ragams, but in any raga you sing, that swaram should sound nice. If you sing in Hamsa Dhani, how will you sing this Adi Talam? Or at least you should first learn to say it rhythmically. 5, 7, 9, 11. How can you say that rhythmically? Sit comfortably. Takatakita is correct. Takadimi takita is also correct. That is 7. Then takadimi takatakita is 9. Then takatakadimi takatakita is also 11. That's in theory it's fine. But if you sing it like that, they won't understand what is where, which taka comes from, which taka, and which is takatakadimi takatakita means if you keep doing. It won't be that this thing, right? So it has to stand out. Every pattern has to stand out. So, taka takita, if you do, keep adding one karvai. Taka takita, ta ding genato ta ding genato ta ding genato ta. Kariva ni parita ni parivat ni bhagavani bhagarivata piganapatim. Or, kariva ni parita ni pandita ni bhagavani bhagadeva. Taka taketa tadingena 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 toma. So what you are doing is you are just adding that one karvai to make it sound smarter. You understand? So everything about smart is about not only thinking smart but also delivering smart. Now if you have this in some other raga, like Pantwarali. Sarasaksha paripalaya garivani dharivani dappasani dappa magama pada nisarasaksha, like that. So this is just one small example using 32. Now if you want 30 or if you want 28 or anything, you extrapolate the same patterns. Now for example, why I was saying this is the pattern should sound nice musically. 2, 6, 10 and 14, musically it won't sound that nice. It won't work. In theory it will work, but musically. It won't sound that aesthetic. So that is where the musical, if you get a concept on paper, try it out in some 10, 20, 30, 40, 50 different ragas, different songs. As soon as you get a concept, try it out several times. In several ways, several contexts. And now these things will even work if the song starts after 2, for instance. Shiva, 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 Yanarada. If you do this. Taka, Shiva, Shiva. So it starts after 2, right? So if you want to start a pattern from samam but end in 2, plus 2 basically. How will you do that? Total number is 34. So how are you going to find the 4 pattern, 4 terms? Eight, 9 means 7, 8, 9, 10, right? It's not Einsteinian level calculation required to say what are the previous and the last terms also. Right? Think of it from that first term. Get the middle terms and get the extreme terms also immediately. Right? 7, 8, 9, 10. So, should sound good. Just don't do one continuous thing. It'll be like noodles. Nobody will know which is the beginning, which is the end of the next phrase or anything. Right? So it should be separated. Each phrase has to be separated nicely. So how many ways you can do this just in that one song, one landing? So that is what is depth of creativity. Creativity is just the first level of calculation, is just the first level of that. It's just the surface of it, right? Then go deeper and deeper and explore it in so many different angles, different facets. That's why good artists will have at least one option for every possibility. Whereas a great artist will have multiple options for the same possibility. That means extra amount of quality time invested, and then you should have the sense to choose what is the best option for that particular concert or for that particular accompanist, what will be comfortable for that particular mridangist. Otherwise he'll be in some other wavelength, not tuned in, then the whole thing will be complete disaster, right? So we have to be very careful about how we tap into their talent and get the best out of the whole team. And that is the next part of concert thinking. Just we perfect something and then until we go and sing it, our head will be in some high-wired, high-sprung kind of one feel. There's no point to that. Aha, we finished that idea. Okay, now we can go to the next. We shouldn't be that way. We should have so many different ideas, but it should be the luxury of our choice. What idea we present when, how. You all understand, right? What I'm giving is a very, very simple example now. Now, I came up with this concept of expressing anything in four terms instead of all the time thinking only three. Most of the Carnatic choruses are always centered around three or something, right? So instead of that, here is a concept of doing four terms, but it will still sound smart and compelling. Obvious rule here is if the number is divisible by four, then the four terms will be odd numbers with a difference of two. If the number is non-divisible by four, it will be four successive terms. Take any example and see, you will be able to easily verify this. Okay? So all these data points should be there somewhere in our brain. And when we are sitting or singing on the stage or playing on the stage, we'll get ideas at lightning speed. We'll be able to get it because we would have had the key to those ideas. You get it? I also wanted to take some time to discuss about some other smart finishes and seamless choruses and all that, but I think we are running out of time. So there is a YouTube recording of my demonstration on seamless choruses, which was given in the Music Academy a few years back. So if you just Google it and YouTube it, search it, you'll be able to get that seamless choruses. That's a higher concept than what I'm talking about now. But I'll explain the gist of that concept in a couple of minutes so that you can all go and ruminate over it. Adithalam, one kalai has 32 units, right? Two kalai, how many units are there? So now, is 64 a big korvai? Will generally have two parts at least, two distinctive parts. Tad dit takadinatam will be the first part. Then the second part will be takadagita takadimi takita takadimi takadagita, some such thing. You will feel that. So now, if you want the second part to have a finish of 3/7, how much should be the first part? How many units should be the first part? 43. 64 minus 21, basically, right? So now 43, is it divisible by 3? It's a prime number. Actually, it's not divisible by anything other than itself and 1, right? So how can you make the first part into 43 so that you have this second part as 3 sevens. That is the concept of seamless query. Similarly, if you want to have three nines, three sankirnams as you finish, then how can you do that? How much do we need for the first part? No, 37. Yeah, okay. So again, that's another prime number. So how can you make that? Intelligently, you can't just simply do some 5 plus 22 plus some 10 that you can't say and call it first part. No. It has to be mathematically progressive in some intelligent way, which is rational, aesthetic, at the same time scientific. Okay? So this is the problem that seamless coreway as a concept aims to address. Because people cannot do this usually, they end up putting some carveys in between. Now, for example, ta ka ta ki ta ta ka ta ki ta ka ta ka ta ki ta. If you do this, you will be left with 19. So what people will do, ta ka ta ki ta ta ka ta ki ta ta ka ta ki ta is 3 fives, which is going to be 15. Then you are still left with 4. So they will give two carveys in between. Ta ka ta ki ta tam ta ka ta ki ta tam ta ka ta ki ta is what they will do. So in other words, that is a filler that we are doing because we are not able to get these 3 taketaketas across. Okay? So there are some ways in which you can overcome that. Go check out that recording. Okay? Okay. I think I've been requested to extend it a little more. So, the seamless coreway concept, you will have to get a little bit out of the box thinking for you to actually be able to work. Now, before we go to that, let's actually get a little more of some more basic small things taken care of. There is this concept of being able to express any even number as a sum of 3 terms. The first term will have 3 units, second will have 2 units, and the third will have just 1 unit. Now, for example, ta ka ta ki ta. How much is it? 3 units for that 5, right? 15. So, 2 units for that 6. And takadimi takita. Just 1 unit for that 7. So how much does it add up to? Takadimi takadimi takita. It's 5 into 3, 6 into 2, 7 into 1. How much is it? 34, right? So now, how will you think it in a composition? Like this. So, how can we express that concept? Five into 3, 6 into 2. Right? That's just one way to do that. Now, a student of mine who is in about 7th or 8th standard came up with a formula that any number can be expressed in this form, 3 plus 2 plus 1, any even number. So that formula he calls as 6n plus 4d, where n will be the first number and d will be the difference between the first number and the subsequent numbers. Now in this example, n is 5. That's the first number which has 3 carveys. Second number is how much? 6. So that means the difference between 5 and 6 is just 1, right? Similarly, between that and next one is 1. So the D is 1 and N is 5. So this is a concept that he came with. So now any even number, just tell me one number. 28. So keep subtracting 4 from the 28 until you get to a number that is divisible by 6. So 28 minus 4? 24, right? So that means 24 by 6 is 4. That means that first number will be 4. And how many times did you subtract? Only once. So the difference will be 1. So if you try 4, 5, 6. So try it. How much is 4 into 3? 5 into 2? 6 into 1? Add all the 3? You got 28, right? So this is a formula. It's a very, very smart thing that child shared with me. So think of any number. Now, how to apply this in songs? This is the main thing. This is where we are all heading. We are not just going to be writing mathematic books with this. We have to deliver it on the stage. Now, if you look at a Mishra Chapu composition, 28 is there, right? You can apply this in that kind of a composition. Try to sing this. Gari sani, risani dapa, rifani dapa masya. Whatever. Okay? So this is just one way to do this. Now if you want to extend it, take some other number. Just for us to get the brain working, think of some good number. You can double that. But when you double that, you don't have to double this actually like this. You don't have to do it 8, 10 and 12, you don't have to do. When you do 56, calculate for 56 itself. Keep subtracting that 4. How much is that? 52. That is not divisible by 6. Then subtract another 4. No, 8, because you subtracted 2 times, right? So 8, 10 and 12. So try to sing that now. How will you sing 8, 10 and 12? Idea is for us to be able to sing it nicely in that particular raga. Try. Not you guys. Anybody who has not...
That's the mic also. I think back row, you have strikes.
Any row, end the row, Mahanubhavulu. So. Tell me. That's one way to do that. But if you sing it melodically like that, the separation won't be shown correctly. And many times, in the raga also, it won't come through nicely. So these are all the issues that a musician faces. A melody artist has to be more conscious of what will work for the raga. For mridangist, it's much, much easier. Tatom, tati ketatom, takitatom, tati ketatom, takatakitatom, tati ketatom, the one way to do that. Ta, tati ketatom, so many ways even a mridangist can express it. And then the mridangist has to see which will be nice for that particular occasion. So similarly, melodically,
gari,
kind of thing. So 3 plus 5, 3 plus 7, 3 plus 9 kind of thing. Gadi or Sai Gadi Sani the Ni Ritsani the Pada Sani Sani the Pamasya. So see which will work nicely for the raga. Just don't sing Sani the Pamagamapa Rithani the Pamagamapa Gadi Sani the Pani the Pamagamapa. Means it will not be aesthetically nice, even though the math is correct, it's still right. So now it is like this for this particular raga. If you want it for say Riti Gaula, if you want to do it like that. So how will you do that there? Sama gama gadita nisa dritsa nidama gama gama nidama nidama samu. Just one option. You can even do better than that. Sagadri gamani nisa nisa gadri gamani nisa gadri sagadri gamagani nisa masamu. So you have to keep singing and seeing, or playing and seeing which sounds nice for the raga. Magari gamani ni so each time you can keep improving your previous effort by getting it closer to the raga, closer to the song, closer to the context, closer to the beauty of music. Get the picture? So just small things can still need, how much of time investment we now needed for just one small finish, right? The theory is the easiest part of it. Take any number now, keep working on the theory for a few times, you will start getting this calculation much faster. Right? But then, when it comes to practice, that is where art is so much the beginning of where science ends. Where science ends, art begins. Where theory ends, practice begins. Do you get the picture, right? And that is why it is so immense. Now the same concept in mathematics textbook, it's just one thing, right? 6n plus 4d is just one concept in a textbook. It's just one small set of two terms for the whole formula. That's the end of mathematics over there. But that's only the beginning of music. For each raga, suppose you know some 200 compositions in Mishra Japu, you will have to work out for each one of those ragams. If you are a passionate artist, you will end up doing that. Nido charanamule Simendra Madhyamam Marivere Anand Bhairavi. So like this, different ragas, you'll have to keep doing it. But the good news here is that if you try it for even some 10 ragas, then rest of it will start coming automatically to you by the time you finish this. So you don't have to actually work out for all the 200 ragas or 200 songs and all this. By the time you get this, you'll start developing that intuition. Again, I talked about this, right? More and more you are able to develop intuition. Better your instincts, the musical instinct. That is what is called jnanam. What I taught you now is vidya. It is a fact, factual knowledge what I taught you now. But the application of that is all jnanam about. So if a tiger is coming and attacking you, nobody is going to be sitting with one megaphone in their hand and saying, take two steps back at three feet intervals each, then turn around, about turn, then run faster, accelerate at the rate of 3.5 miles per second kind of things. Nobody is going to be saying all this to you, right? You just code for the thing, right? That's what instinct is about. So in other words, if you boil down that number of steps that that person actually has to take to escape the tiger, not the probability is high, but anyway, still, if you have to do that, you will be actually having so many hundreds of steps before that guy is actually safe home. So, same for music also. The sooner you develop the instinct, things will become like far more simpler. What is 100 steps in a theory book will be just one step for you. Similarly, what is one step in that formula will become like 100 different things in your hands. You can bring 100 different dimensions to that formula. That's the beauty of art. Okay? So, been very happy to share all these thoughts with such intelligent students. I thank SVN Academy and Bharati Vidya Bhavan for this wonderful opportunity. Yeah, thank you very much.